Hello everyone, this is Sudipto from Technical Potpourri, and today I'm going to talk about the new improved conditional directives which you can use in LWC starting from Salesforce Spring 23 release. So no more if true, if false. It will be a new conditional directive that is coming up with Spring 23 release. So let's check it out. So this is a very basic LWC component, and what this component is doing, I have exposed two property. One is name, another is display. Display is a boolean and name is a string. What it is doing, it is checking what is the value of display. If it is true, then it is printing hello name. If it is false, it is printing hello nothing. So let's put that in the home page and see how it works. So here I am in the home page. Let me edit the page and put the LWC component there. So here is my LWC component. I'm going to put it here. Let me put my name and should display. This is a boolean variable. It's true, and then save and then come back. You can see that since the value is true, boolean is showing the and followed by the name. Now, if I make it false, if I make it false here, uncheck this one and come back, it's showing hello nothing. This is the if true and if false. Now with the introduction of Spring 23, you don't need to write if true and if false. Rather, you can replace your if true with LWC if. And here you can write LWC else, and you don't need to give this anymore. And let's deploy these changes to the org. It's deployed. So let's go to the org again and do a refresh. As you can see, it's the same effect. You can still see the same impact. So let's make a change. And let's change the boolean value to false. And save and come back. And you can see that it's showing hello nothing. So basically, you can replace your old code with LWC if and LWC else. So now the definite question that is coming to your mind, why suddenly this change? What is the reason behind that? So let's understand that. So chaining if true and if false blocks introduced some performance cost and resulted in the property getters getting called multiple times. But with the introduction of this new LWC if and LWC else for LWC else, which is called basically the conditional directives, the property getters are accessed only one time per instance of the directive. So it's not getting called multiple times, rather it's getting called only one time per instance of the directive. And this is the way how Salesforce is solving the performance cost problem. The old if true and if else are no longer recommended, and what Salesforce is telling is that they are planning to depreciate and remove these directives in future. So the recommendation is that if you are still dealing with if true and if false, starting Spring 23, you should replace those with LWC if and LWC else or else if. Though there is one thing that you need to remember, if you are dealing with any complex expressions like what is shown in the screen, they are not supported yet in LWC if and LWC else. But to evaluate those complex expressions, it is recommended to use a getter in the JavaScript class. So I hope this short video is helpful. Please hit the like icon and share, and please subscribe to my channel so that you get update about all my upcoming videos. Till then, thank you and happy learning.